السلام عليكم. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين سيدنا محمد وآله أجمعين. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. رب أوزعني أن أشكر نعمتك التي أنعمت علي وعلى والدي وأن أعمل صالحا ترضاه وأصلح لي في ذريتي إني تبت إليك وإني من المسلمين. My dear brothers in Iman, the time we live in is a time that is to many very strange. Things that are natural and that are logical, which people should appreciate and understand, specifically for people of faith, believers, and especially for Muslims, it should be taken seriously. Because the Quran, being the source of knowledge for Muslims, it is like the manual through which we can live our life. But it is shocking in this day and age, we find a lot of the people of the world are still lacking the understanding of their presence of the earth. Hence, we have a lot of difficulties and problems. And in the last maybe 15, 20 years, we could see the problems that are taking place. For example, you see the problems of people like the Rohingyas and the discrimination that they go through. You could see every day almost in the news the discrimination against what they call the untouchables in India, which is a very sad fact for a nation that is supposed to have a great history of humanity. You could see the discrimination that is taking place in many of our countries, even so-called free countries or countries that hold and fight for freedom, like Britain and France and America, and the discrimination that takes place against minorities and specifically people of African descent. I was astonished because this week in all the schools and colleges, universities in this country and many countries, they speak about the history of Africa. And the reason is because they see that children from Africa in schools, universities, colleges are being discriminated against because the image of Africa in television and in the media is the poorest continent, is backward, is the place where all illnesses are, and people are still living in the jungle, and so on. It is sad for any human being to think like that, but it's specifically for believers and especially for Muslims. Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, being the man that was chosen to bring to this world some mercy, as Allah said in the Quran, we are not sent to you, O Muhammad, only as a mercy to the worlds. Not just to our human world, to all the worlds. In the Quran that he delivered, in regard of this issue, Allah said, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم ومن آياته and of his signs. أن خلقكم من تراب, that he created you from dust. ثُمَّ إِذَا أَنْتُمْ بَشَرٌ تَنْتَشِرُونَ. Thereafter, you are human beings scattered on the earth. ومن آياته and of his signs أن خلق لكم من أنفسكم أزواجا لتسكنوا إليها وجعل بينكم مودة ورحمة إن في ذلك لآيات لقوم يتفكرون. That he has created for each one of you from yourself a partner to be married to, a wife or a husband that you will marry and live with, and he made between you love and mercy. However, in this there are signs for men and women who reflect, who think, why did Allah do that? وَمِنْ آيَاتِهِ خَلْقُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ And of his signs, the creation of the heavens. And how great the heavens are. Galaxies, planets, stars, and so on. Too many things that we don't even understand or know. And the earth, and everything in it. And we don't know everything about the earth. وَاخْتِلَافِ أَلْسِنَتِكُمْ وَأَلْوَانِكُمْ And the differing of your languages and your colors. إِنَّ فِي ذَلِكَ لَآيَاتٍ لِلْعَالِمِينَ However, in this, there are signs for men and women of knowledge. Allah is linking the test He is putting us in making us all different. Only understood by those who have knowledge. These three verses, each one of you, when you go home, open the Quran, Surah Ar-Rum. Verses 20, 21, and 23. Read them. These verses are very, very important. In madrasas of Quran, where I studied, we learn those verses from verse 17 to 27. فَسُبْحَانَ اللَّهِ حِينَ تُمْسُونَ وَحِينَ تُصْبِحُونَ وَلَهُ الْحَمْدُ فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ وَعَشِيًّا وَحِينَ تُظْهِرُونَ All those verses from there to the end, we read them in the morning and in the evening. We memorize them because Allah is talking about His signs for those who reflect, for those who understand, for those who have knowledge, and so forth. In these three verses, Allah is telling us if you discriminate against one another, you are naive, you are foolish, you don't think, you have no knowledge. Because you all came from a man made from the mud. From him Allah created his partner, Adam and Hawa. And from both of them, you all come. You all go back to him. كُلُّكُمْ لِآدَمْ وَآدَمْ مِنْ تُرَابٍ The Prophet ﷺ said. You are all from Adam and Adam from the dust. Very funny. When people discriminate against one another, when your father, your source is one source. And then he says, there are greater things that I created, like the heavens and the earth and everything in it. You are just a part of that creation. But I made differing in your languages. What did Adam used to speak? What are his children used to speak? When all the differing of the languages started, here, we need to think. The first man, Adam, when he was brought to the earth, where did he land? The majority of the people who understand the teaching, Adam alayhi salam and Hawa landed in Africa. And Allah driven them across to the east to Mecca. Where the Kaaba today is, they kneel. And Allah inspired them, رَبَّنَا ظَلَمْنَا أَنفُسَنَا وَإِنْ لَمْ تَغْفِرْ لَنَا وَتَرْحَمْنَا لَنَكُونَنَّ مِنَ الْخَاسِرِينَ Oh Allah, we have wronged ourselves, eight from the three. And now we are on the earth, we should be in the heavens. But we are wrong. If you do not forgive us, we will be losers. Allah brought from the heaven the black stone. And subhanAllah, they held it, they kissed it, they understood it. It's not from here. It's from that world. Are we going to go back? Allah says, no. The malaika will build a house. In one of its corners, this black stone will be put. From it you start and to it you return. If you kissed it, And if you kiss the hand of the Almighty God and He has no hand like our hands. But by going around it, you realize from Him you came and to Him you retain spiritually. But from the earth you were created and your physical bodies will be buried on the earth. This is what Allah wants us to learn. So when we meet Allah, this is what we think about. إِنَّا لِلَّهِ وَإِنَّا إِلَيْهِ رَاجِعُونَ Adam has children. And from the beginning, the problem started of the discrimination Allah is talking about. And one of his descendants, Sayyidina Idris alayhi salam, where did he start? And they say, Idris alayhi salam is the man who started the languages, the institutions, and the knowledge. That was also in Africa. The greatest institution for learning knowledge in the world, the oldest, is in a place whereby only a few years back, some naive Muslim one day want to burn everything. A place called Timbuktu in Mali. There was the greatest institution for knowledge. Everybody from anywhere in the world wanted to go there to see what those people are doing. I went there. I visited there. I found the library with over 1 million manuscripts. Million! And then I was shocked, I found a lady, a woman, who owned a library with 400,000 manuscripts. And guess what? Who is helping her to maintain those old books? They're not just normal books. I was shocked. One of the books, you could read the line from right to left, one book about a subject. But if you turn the world and read that direction, is another book. And even more fascinating, you read from the top down, like Chinese, there is a third book. Many of these books never been printed. As far as I know, there is only one being printed by the royal family of Qatar, and they only give it to distinguished guests. Because these are very valuable, important way of understanding. There are people who live before us who are greater in knowledge. In Africa, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when he went to Mi'raj, he said, the greatest of the rivers, the Euphrates, the Dijla wal Furat in Iraq, and the Nile of Africa. All prophets either lived in Jerusalem and Sham area, where Palestine is now, or lived in Africa, the valley of the Nile. All great knowledge was between three places, Sham, Hijaz, and Africa. Until when the British came, the Kaaba today will go and go around, everything that it needs came from Africa. Sayyidina Musa alayhi salam lived in Africa. Sayyidina Yusuf alayhi salam lived in Africa. When his people came, they didn't come to a continent whereby people are backward and they don't understand. There are great civilizations. They had kingdoms, they had empires, and they had sultanates. Until the British and the French came to Africa, in every corner there was a sultanate, an empire, or a kingdom. There were 35 greatest kingdoms and sultanate emperors living in the world. When you look at Ethiopia, subhanAllah, amazing. That nation has one of the greatest civilizations ever the world has seen. In that nation, recently, in the 20th century, they found some remains of humans to be of the fairest to start, to prove this. Sayyidina Musa alayhi salam and Khidr alayhi salam, they did not meet outside, they met in Africa. There are great things to be said. If your son, your daughter come to you from school, asking you, this week we have a week about studying about Africa, it would be sad to say, I don't know. I will finish with this. Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the first people to be saved, he did not send them to Persia, he did not send them to Europe, he did not send them to Yemen, he sent them to Africa. What did he say to them? He said to them, go and cross the Red Sea, Uthman, and those who are able to go with you, and including my daughter Ruqayyah. For it is the land of truth. It's the land of justice. It's the land of people forgiving one another. It's the land of freedom, a land of consultation. And in it, there are people who live together harmoniously. Among them kings, you will not wrong anyone. So these are things that we need to understand. And today, my message to everybody, don't judge people by the language they speak, because sometimes people laugh at other languages. Don't judge people by their colors, because at the end of the day, we all come from the dust. And we are all the children of Adam, as the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, you are all from Adam, and Adam from dust. May Allah reward me and reward you, and give us tawfiq, inshallah. Shukran.